गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, दिस इज सृष्टि एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द होल स्टोरी ऑफ ओजोन डिप्लीशन. सो डिड यू नो दैट ओजोन इज असेंशियल फॉर लाइफ? इट्स मॉलिक्यूल्स एक्ट एज अ शील्ड प्रोटेक्टिंग अस फ्रॉम सोलर रेडिएशन और यूवी रेज विच आर हार्मफुल फॉर द बायोस्फीयर एंड कॉजेज डिजीजेस. When the radiation reaches the ozone layer, it passes through the ozone molecules. And these ozone molecules are responsible for returning a large part of radiation back to the space. And in this way, the radiation that reaches us is minimized. So let's know a little bit more about ozone. So ozone is a form of oxygen present in the lower layer of the stratosphere, which is O3. It is present in rare amounts in the atmosphere. Ozone acts as a barrier and protects us from the UV rays, I've said this before, and it also protects the biosphere from extra heat. So we've studied about ozone, we know about ozone now. So let's come to the point. What is ozone depletion? Ozone depletion is basically the wearing off of ozone from the lower stratosphere. And a large example is the ozone hole. So what is a ozone hole now? It is this hole that allows the entry of large amount of UV light. And it is located at the poles on the Antarctic continent and the Arctic Ocean. This becomes especially large during the spring of both hemispheres and it results in longer summer seasons. So now we know about the ozone layer. We are aware about the ozone depletion. Now let's come to the causes. Why is it happening? So ozone decreases by sunlight acting on a number of air pollutants emitted from aircrafts, hydrocarbons, automobile exhausts. Also chlorofluorocarbon, commonly known as CFC, is a great cause of ozone depletion. So what happens is the CFC escapes from our refrigerators or ACs and it goes up to the stratosphere and finally breaks down into chlorine. Now again, chemicals like chlorine and bromine deplete the ozone layer and thus this is harmful. Large eruptions from volcanoes are also responsible for the same because these speed up the destructive chemical reactions. So why is the hole harmful? Although this hole is due to the natural fluctuation of ozone in the atmosphere, a large part of it is also caused by human activities. We are the ones using cars, ACs, refrigerators, aircrafts, which emit gases that end up in the stratosphere and degrade the ozone molecules, increasing the size and effect of the hole in this layer. And this is an environmental and health problem, since the excess of solar radiation is a threat to any form of life. So what this solar radiation is a threat to the biosphere and the ozone layer is protecting it. And what we are doing is we are carelessly depleting it. So there will come a time when the ozone layer will be depleted to such an extent that we will be exposed to the UV rays and this will make the life on Earth very difficult. So we have to take some preventions. And speaking of prevention, we are going to head on to the next slide, which is prevention. The first point says avoid the consumption of gases dangerous to the ozone layer. Because what happens is these gases rise up to the stratosphere and deplete the ozone molecules. And thus, the hole gets bigger and bigger. So some of the most dangerous gases are given below. The second point says minimize the use of cars. The best way to do this is either take public transport, bicycle, or try walking if the distance is not too much. If it's a great distance and you have to take a car, then try carpool. It is very fun and you can always contribute to the environment by polluting less. Number 3, do not use cleaning products that are harmful to the environment and to us. Instead, you can replace these by non-toxic products such as vinegar or bicarbonate. Point 4 is buy local products. So the first thing about it is that you consume fresh products and you avoid the consumption of food that has traveled long distance. And the second thing about is the more distance traveled, the more nitrous oxide is produced due to the medium used to transport that product. So just by buying local products, you are decreasing the amount of nitrous oxide produced in the environment. Number five, and the most important one, is maintain air conditioners. So their malfunction is the main cause of CFC to escape into the environment. That's all. Thank you for hearing me out and have a good day.